Welcome to Christ Virtual Church. Hey, it is so good to spend this time with you today. Thank you for being a part of our worship celebration and really a part of our ministry. This comes to you today from my heart to your home. And I mean, think about this right now. Think about this. How can you even begin to describe how great our God is? I mean, think about it. He spoke and galaxies flew into existence. He said the words, "Let there be light," and light came bursting forth at a speed of 186,000 miles per second. He is all-powerful and all-knowing. Well, here's our band recorded live in worship with "How Great is Our God." Happy Sunday! Well, you know, life is full of disappointments. Maybe you didn't get that promotion that you worked so hard for. Maybe that loan fell through. Maybe that friend let you down. And we're kind of like, wow, that was really bad. I mean, that didn't work out like at all. My prayers didn't come true at all. Well, here's what I want you to understand. God won't allow you to go through any experience. God won't allow you to go through any difficulty unless he's going to somehow use it for your good. You may not understand how he's going to do that, but if you'll keep the right attitude, everything that happens in life will push you. It will push you toward something good. And once you understand this principle about life, it's going to change your entire perspective. You don't get so upset when a coworker plays politics at the office and tries to leave you out, because you know it's all good. God allowed it, and he's going to use it. You tried, and that business idea of yours didn't work out, but you don't give up on your dreams, because you know it's all good. It's all a part of the process. You don't let simple little things ruin your entire day, you know, like getting stuck in traffic. You know that if you're getting stuck in traffic, well, God is directing your steps. So maybe God is keeping you from an accident up ahead. Maybe God is trying to teach you patience. Whatever it is, he has a purpose in it. Keep the right perspective. It's all good. It really boils down to trusting God. God knows where the dead ends are. God knows where the shortcuts are. God knows where the bumpy roads are that are to cause you pain and anxiety and heartache. And he keeps certain doors closed that you prayed would open up for you, because he knows if you walk through those open doors, it's just going to be a waste of time for you. You've just got to say, God, I trust you. I trust that you know what's best for me. Here's the basic principle. All things work together for good. All things work together for good, says the Bible, for those who love God. It doesn't say some things. It doesn't say most things. It says all things. They may not be good at the time that we go through them. It's painful to go through a loss. It hurts when people do you wrong. It's discouraging when your dreams don't work out. And by themselves, these events might not be good. But God promises he'll bring it all together. You say, Jeff, well, I don't know about that. I mean, Jeff, I'm broken because I've lost someone I love. I'm bitter because my business partner cheated me. I'm bummed out because I didn't get that job. Jeff, those things can't be good. Well, the problem is that you're isolating single events. God hasn't brought it all together yet. Let me give you an example. Think of Good Friday. We celebrate Good Friday every year, and we call it good now. But 2,000 years ago, if you were there watching Jesus hanging upon the cross being crucified, it wouldn't look like a Good Friday to you. The disciples thought it was the worst day of their entire lives. Their dreams were shattered. The man they devoted their lives to was dead and buried. Doubts filled their minds. They must have been thinking, maybe he wasn't who we thought he was. Maybe he lied to us. Maybe we've wasted all this time. In fact, can you imagine the way Mary felt? Mary, the mother of Jesus, weeping as she saw her son hanging on that cross, the blood dripping into the sand, the sweat and the grime streaking his face, his chest heaving, lungs gasping for air. She was heartbroken. She was in so much pain. If someone had suggested to her, Mary, this is a Good Friday, she would say, what, are you crazy? You think this is good? Look at what's happening. The lesson for us is, Good Friday may not feel good. Good Friday may not feel good. We all face times in our own life, times that don't make sense, times that don't feel good. When the dream dies, when the relationship ends, we come down with an illness we have to wrestle with. Nothing about that situation seems good. And if you had been there that day 2,000 years ago and stood at the foot of the cross watching your Savior die, good is the last word you would have used to describe that Friday. Tragic Friday. Betrayed Friday. Lonely Friday. Those would have been more accurate descriptions. But a few days later, when Jesus rose from the dead, then God brought it all together. They realized He was who He said He was, and He could do what He said He could do. He defeated death. He broke the hold that Satan had on us, and He swung open the gates of heaven for the likes of you and I. They looked back on that Friday and they said, it wasn't at all, not at all what we thought it was. It wasn't depressing Friday. It wasn't tragic Friday. It was good Friday. It was all a part of God's plan. When they look back, what they thought was the worst day of their life, they now called good. What am I saying? It's all good. It may not feel good when you're going through it. It may not make sense when you're in the middle of it, but God knows how to bring it all together. Now, that's why I try to remember this thought. I try to remember that God wants to change your question marks into exclamation points. Change your question marks into exclamation points. Think about it. An exclamation point is simply a question mark that has been straightened out. We all have question marks in life, things that we don't understand, things that don't make sense to us. But if we want God to turn that question mark into an exclamation point, we have to give God some time and trust Him to straighten things out. In those dark places when life isn't fair, instead of wondering why this is happening or that's not happening, dare to say, I know that God is still on His throne. I may be going through a dark valley right now, but I know that on the other side of this valley, there's going to be an exclamation point for me. The right people are waiting on the other side of the valley. The right opportunities are waiting for me on the other side of the valley. I know that God is going to amaze me with His goodness. If you go through those kind of dark places, well, you're going to see that question mark turned into an exclamation point in your life. That's what happened to one man. He would visit the hospital every week with volunteer basis. He would go in and visit people and just kind of give them his smile and maybe say a little prayer with them. Well, one day this man parks his car and he's crossing the street in front of the main entrance to this hospital. And suddenly, the speeding car came barreling along and ran right into him, hit him, hurled him up over the hood onto the blacktop. Well, they rushed him into the emergency room and took a full body scan looking for broken bones and internal bleeding. Remarkably, he was fine. But they did discover a dark spot on his kidney. It was a tumor. When they did a biopsy, they found it was cancer. He was brought into emergency surgery to remove the kidney, and today he is cancer-free. But his doctor told him, if we hadn't spotted that tumor right at that moment, well, that cancer would have spread throughout your body, and it would have been life-threatening for you. Getting hit by that car that day saved his life. Friend, that's an exclamation mark to end that story. That man just had to wait for God to straighten everything out, to take that question mark, God, why did you let this happen to me? And turn it into an exclamation mark. Thank God it happened. It saved my life. And write this down if you're taking notes. You get blessings through breakings. Understand, you get blessings through breakings. You may be in a dark place right now and you may feel broken. Maybe you're heartbroken. Somebody broke up with you, somebody you thought you had a future with, and now you're lonely and you're wondering if you're ever going to be happy again. Well, believe me when I tell you, your best days are still ahead. There is an exclamation point in your future. Maybe your health is broken. You're dealing with a sickness. You didn't expect this. The doctors are telling you it doesn't look good. But keep on trusting God. Keep on trusting God, because that exclamation point is coming. Maybe you're just plain flat broke. You're struggling with your finances. You had a setback. You lost a major client, and you're wondering, is it ever going to bounce back? Is it ever going to get better for me? Well, you may be in that valley right now, but you need to get ready. God's going to straighten this out. Your question mark is about to turn into an exclamation point. That's what happened to one man who received devastating medical news. The doctor said because of an eye infection that he had, he was going to lose his eyesight. He would have to undergo this terrible surgery that would leave him completely blind. Well, amazingly, he came through the surgery and he had perfect vision. Now every morning he wakes up and just thanks God for all his blessings. He takes 15 minutes and he just watches his children. He just looks at the sunlight on the flowers. He looks at the leaves on the trees. He didn't realize at the time, but in that dark place, in that broken place, he was being blessed. He was being blessed and he'd never feel the same again. You get blessings through breakings. When Jesus had to feed a multitude of people numbering in the thousands, all he had to work with was one little boy's lunch, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. The Bible says he held up the loaves of bread. He gave thanks, and then the Bible says he broke the loaves, and the bread was multiplied. Notice the blessing was in the breaking. The more he broke it, the more it multiplied. There are times in your life when you're going to feel broken. We have broken dreams, broken heart. Maybe you're in a dark place right now. And if that describes you, I want you to know I'm really sorry that you're in that place in your life right now. I'm really sorry that you're going through this. And I want you to know that I've been through it too. And you're going to come out on the other side of this. And there's one final thing you should know, though. Darkness brings out the greatness. Believe me when I tell you, darkness brings out the greatness in you. Think about a seed. You can have an apple seed sitting on your desk for decades, and it will never become an apple tree until you put it in the ground. Its potential will never be released until it is planted. As long as it's sitting there on your desk, well, it'll stay nice and comfortable. It will not have to stretch and deal with adversity. And that seed's potential, however, will stay locked up on the inside. If you were to somehow ask that seed, I'm sure it would say, but I don't want to go into the dirt. It's dark. It's lonely. It's uncomfortable if people walk all over you. The seed feels as though it's being buried, as though this is the end. But what that seed doesn't know is that it's not buried, it's planted. It has the life force of Almighty God on the inside of it. And that dark place, buried in the dirt, that's what's going to bring forth the beautiful flower. That's what's going to produce the fruit. That's what's going to bring the growth. That's why Jesus said, unless a kernel of wheat is planted in the soil and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it will produce much fruit. You may feel today like you're in a dark place. None of us likes to be planted. It's uncomfortable. It's lonely. But in those dark places, you have to remind yourself that new growth is on the way. Even though it feels like something's dying, something else is coming to life. You're not buried. You're planted. When you come out, you're going to bear much fruit. My challenge to you is this. Be willing to go through the process. Dare to trust God. You're not buried, you're planted. It's just a matter of time before you break out and blossom into who you were created to be. If you'll go through those dark places with a good attitude, God is going to take your question marks and turn them into exclamation points. Because folks, never forget, it's all good. Let's bow our heads and go before our God. Dear God, I want to be honest with you. I feel like I've had a lot of bad things happen to me in my lifetime. Things that did nothing but pull me down. Nothing good ever came of it. But then it's like I hear you whispering softly in my ear, "Hold on, you don't know what I'm doing behind the scenes. It may not have all come together yet. It may not be straightened out yet, but I know what I'm doing." So, Father, I guess that's what faith is all about. When things happen that I don't like, disappointments, betrayals, bad breaks, I can get negative and live bitter, or I can say, "God, I trust you. I trust you because you know what's best for me. Even though I don't understand it, I believe once you straighten this out, it's going to work for me, not against me. This is just going to be another exclamation point when I tell people my life story." And if you've never invited Jesus to be a part of your life, I encourage you to pray this simple prayer with me right now. Dear Jesus, I want you in my life as my friend and my Savior. You are the most positive, powerful personality who ever lived. Straighten out my situation. Bless my brokenness. Forgive my sins. And one day, take me home to be with you in heaven. I humbly pray this in your name. Amen. Now I invite you to join me as we pray that prayer that the Lord Jesus taught us to pray. We pray together right now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, my friend, if I could give you one thing, I would give you my Jesus. He is my strongest supporter. He is my truest friend. He is my eternal Savior. Here's our band recorded live in worship with my Jesus.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all its stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life.
Jesus.
tell you about my Jesus. Oh, he makes a way where there ain't no way, rises up from an empty.
Well, I thank you so much for being with us right now, and I want to invite you to join us again next week for another week of Encourage You. Next week, I'm going to talk about what to do when life stinks. Because let's be honest, sometimes it feels like life stinks, right? You go through bad breaks, broken dreams, breakups. So I want to give you some encouragement and some proven life strategies straight from God's Word. Well, our final act of worship today is to bring our gift to God. If you would like to give your tithe or your offering, make sure you're on our homepage of our website, clcsouthwick.org. And right there on that homepage, there is a giving tab. And I want to thank every single one of you who supports this ministry with your tithes, with your time, with your thoughts, and especially with your prayers. Thank you so much for being a part of this ministry each and every week. And I give you this blessing right now. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his smile upon you and give you peace. Amen. And go now with joy. We will, for we go with God. Hey, everybody, make it a great week. Only you can. See you next week.